told him the secret. When they know your secret, they know it. And he said, he called the other Philistines together. People know, I have gotten, this one is not like other time. I have gotten the secret. In fact, I have protected. God said, get a razor. Shave the hair. Shave the glory. And the power is gone. While Samson placed his head on the lap of Delilah, imagine that kind of sleep. That while they were busy shaving his head, he never woke up. While men slept, the enemy came to take away the glory. While men slept, the enemy came to shave away the destiny. I can't imagine that I'm putting my head somewhere and somebody is taking razor and clipper and cutting my hair and I will not wake up. Ah! And when they have taken away the power, he just looked at Samson. Samson, the Philistines be upon him. And Samson rose up. And he shook himself like one other. You know, many of us, we are living on past glory. We think the fire is still there, but it's gone. You are like a fan that has been disconnected from the power source. Even though it may still be blowing, but it's just a matter of time. Everything will fade away. The second time I took them out. The third time they were not matched for me. This time also I will deal with them. Do you know that when the Holy Ghost will come sometimes, look at the encounters we had here. Like a rushing mighty wind. But many a times when you will leave unannounced. You will not know it's gone. You just think that you're still dwelling in that globe. But alas, that gentle spirit has gone. And he shook himself as at other time. But the Bible said, looked at himself. He touched his head. The locks were gone. The glory has been shaken. I am finished. I am done for. The man that could pull down buildings, the man that could kill 1,000 Philistines with the jawbone of an axe, became like any other man. He became a grounder in the entertainment hall of the enemies. And the people came together. They said, yes, we have gotten him. They have been on his case for years. They have been on his case for months. They have tried everything they could. They could not get him. Oh, what a celebration when they got him. They say, yes, we have got it. This one will not escape. Do you know that Samson would have still remained alive to do much more greater exploit for God, but his destiny was cut short. Why? Why men slept? The enemy came and sowed tears in the midst of the weeds. And he said, just bring him out, let him come and be a fun sport for us. Do you know that in the heydays of Samson, the Philistines could not stand him? But on this particular time, his eyes were gone. He couldn't see. The man that was a terror to them eventually became a man that offered them fun and sport. They pushed him, he could not raise his hand. They brought him down, he could not stand up. The man that would shake himself would fall, and all Philistines would tremble. Why men slept, the enemy came and sowed tears in the midst of the wind. Why men slept, so it will happen one day that the Lord will burst through the sky. And why men slept, the trumpet may just sound, and everyone that is prepared will be taken up to glory. Good is it to come to giant conference when you don't make it? What good is it to serve the Lord as an usher in the choir, as a prayer warrior, and yet you don't make it to glory? What good is it after all the praying and fasting, after, hey, do this, do that, destiny. The waste. White men slept. The enemy came and sowed tears in the midst of the wheat. You have become a caster out of demons. Your name is recognized in hell. When he kneels down, hell quakes. When he lifts up his voice, something happens. And yet, you don't make it there. White men slept. The enemy came and sowed tears in the midst of the wheat. You become a man that takes advantage of little girls. You put on this spiritual toga. And as a result of that, people that look up to you as a spiritual father, you have taken advantage of them. You have been used by God mightily. But at the end of the day, because of that sin of fornication and of immorality, you have allowed the tears to shock the wheat.